Hey everyone, this is Vikas from Skyline Motions, and today I'm super excited to show you how you can create this amazing Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year greeting animation inside of DaVinci Resolve without using any plugin. It is going to be super easy to create and looks very, very cool. And before we start, if you are watching my video for the very first time, please do consider subscribing and like this video if you enjoyed this tutorial. And no more waiting, let's open DaVinci Resolve and get started. Let's go. Alright, so this is DaVinci Resolve 18.6, and all you have to do the basic setting first. So click on the setting button in the corner and set the size of this project 1920 by 1080. You can create this animation in 4K resolution as well. You can simply select the 4K preset from here, which is the Ultra HD. And then we have to select a frame rate. So in this case, I'm using 60 frames per second for a smooth animation. You can select 24 or 30, whatever you like, and then click on save. Now we have to import some important file for this animation. So just go to media pool, right click on that, click on import media and select these three files. You can download these files from the link in the description, or you can also download the complete project file. I will give you a link in the description. Once you have select the file, click on open. Here we have two different options. So I will click on this don't change because I don't want to change the project setting according to the video clip. So in the first step, I will create a background. Simply drag and drop this video clip on the timeline, just like that. Here, I will use this video clip as a background. I'm gonna place the CTI right over here, select the blade tool, add a cut just like that, and remove this unwanted part. We have to select 6 second long video clip. You can see the timeline here. Set the CTI at 6 second, add a cut by using this blade tool. And then you can delete the unwanted part. So this is a 6 second long video clip that I will use as a background. So what we have to do, just right click on the video clip, click on the new fusion clip and convert it into a fusion clip because I want to match the frame rate and the size according to the project setting. And this is the fusion clip. You can simply click on the text. You can call it background. Perfect. Now this is the background. And after that, we have to create the animated 3D kind of text. So what we have to do, just go to the media pool, right click on that, click on new fusion composition. I'm going to call it text. Duration, make it 6 second long. Frame rate 60, click on create. And this is the fusion composition. Let's drag and drop on the timeline. And after that, we have to create the text in the fusion page. So just go to the fusion page. Here we have the media out node, so just drag this media out to the side for now. And here we have two different viewers, so just click on the single viewer and make it single. Now let's take a new text node. So this is the text tool. Let's drag and drop on the flow window, drag and drop to the viewer to get a preview. And what we have to do the next, select the text tool, go to the inspector window, and here we have to type a text such as Merry Christmas or Happy New Year, just like that. For the Christmas text, I want to use this font style, Heavenly Christmas, which is a free font for personal use, not for commercial. You can download this font style from the link in the description. You can increase the size of the text. I'm gonna set the value 0.2. Perfect. And then we have to set the text in the center. So just right click on the preview window, go to guide and turn on the show guide. And you can set it in the center just like that. It's looking perfect. And then we have to make this text something interesting. So what we have to do, select the text, hit Control plus a space bar for search box and search for create bump map. Hit add button, drag and drop to the viewer. Just go to inspector window and here we have height scale. So let's increase the height scale and set it to 100. And after that, just create a gap between text and this bump map. Select the text, hit Control plus a space bar for search box and search for Gaussian blur. Select the Gaussian blur, hit add button, and then just go to the inspector window and here we have the strength. I'm gonna set the value 0.15 maybe. As you can see, it's looking like this. And after that, we have to apply one more effect, which is erode. So this is the erode delete. Select this effect, hit add button. Just set the amount something around negative 0.0015. Perfect. And now it's looking like this, as you can see. After that, we have to take a new merge node. So this is the merge. Let's drag and drop on the flow window. I'm going to connect the output of this text with this yellow point, which is the background point. And this is the green foreground point. Connect the foreground point with this create bump map. Drag and drop this merge one to the viewer. Select the merge, go to operator and change this over to in. And we will get this effect, as you can see. Deselect all the nodes, hit Ctrl plus a space bar and search for displace. So this is the displace node, hit add button. Select the displace node, connect the green foreground point with this merge. For the background, I will use a fast noise node. Hit Ctrl plus a space bar for search box and search for fast noise. Hit add button and I'm going to connect this fast noise with this yellow background point and drag and drop the displace to the viewer. All right, now select the fast noise, go to color, and here we have to create a gradient color. So select the gradient. Here we have gradient type. I'm going to select linear and set these 2 points right over here, just like that. Perfect. And here we have to select 3 different colors. You can select the first point black, second point also a black color, and add a point in the center. Click on the color and select the white color and make it like this. All right, place the center point right over here. Go to very first frame of this animation, click on the diamond button to create a keyframe. Go to the end of this animation and drag this point right over here, and we will get this type of movement. Now select the displace and here go to type and change this XY, and this is the X refraction and the Y refraction. Just set the X refraction 0.1 and Y refraction 0.1 and make it like this. Alright, and then we have to apply one more effect, which is the brightness and contrast. So select the displace, hit Ctrl plus a space bar. Search for brightness and contrast, drag and drop to the viewer. Select the brightness and contrast, go to setting, and here we have multiply by mask. Check this option and we don't see any changes. So let me show you. This is the mask point. Connect the mask with the output of this text, just like that. And then you can check this option multiply by mask and we will get this effect, as you can see. And here we have the text, which is looking like a 3D text, as you can see. You can also adjust the Gaussian blur, I think so. So you can set this Gaussian blur according to you and make it a good looking text. All right, and finally, select the brightness and contrast, add a transform, drag and drop to the viewer. And let's animate the text. So just go to very first frame of this animation. This is the size property. Right click on that, click on animate and lock the value 1.0 and go to the end of this animation. And let's down the size just a little bit. So I'm going to set the value 0.8 maybe. So we will get this type of zoom out effect, which is looking absolutely perfect. And then you can connect the media out node with this transform and then go to the edit page, and here we have this type of Merry Christmas text. Perfect. And now we have to do one more thing. Just drag and drop the sparkle video clip on the timeline. And I'm going to place this sparkle right over here. You can select any part of this video clip. So I want to use this video clip from here. Simply select the blade tool, add a cut, delete the unwanted part, move the clip right over here. You can add one more cut and delete the extra part. And as usual, we have to convert this into a fusion clip. So just right click on this video clip, click on fusion clip, and this is gonna be the sparkle. Hit enter and then just place the CTI on it. Go to the fusion page and here we have to do some setting. Just select the media in, hit Ctrl plus a space bar for search box and search for the glow effect. So this is the glow. Hit add button. Let's increase the glow size something around 30 or 40 maybe. Perfect. just select the glow, add a CC color corrector, select the color corrector, drag and drop to the viewer, and this is the contrast. Let's increase the contrast and make it more darker. I'm gonna set the value 1.4 maybe, and it's looking perfect. Then just go to the edit page, and here it's looking like this. Just select the sparkle, go to inspector window. This is the composite mode. I'm gonna select this option screen, and now we have nice and simple text animation, which is looking absolutely fantastic, as you can see. Perfect. You can adjust the dark section, so I think just turn off the top layer because I want to edit this text. So just go to the fusion page, and here we have this fast noise. You can see here this is very dark. I'm gonna move this point right over here maybe, and this one right over here. Perfect. And then just go to the edit page. It's looking perfect, and turn on the sparkle, and now we have a nice and simple text. And let me show you how you can create multiple text. Simply select all the clips, hit Control C to copy, place the CDI right over here, hit Control V to paste multiple times. And I want to change the text in the second clip, so simply turn off the top layer, go to fusion page, select the text node, and I'm gonna type a different text, Happy New Year. And then just go to edit page, and here it's looking like this. And for the third one, I want to type 2024, so just place the CDI right over here, go to the fusion page, and this is the text. Select the text, and I want to type 2024. This is the personal use font, so I want to change the font. So this is the lemon milk. I want to select a light font, or maybe regular light is good. And now you can keep it in the center, increase the size just a little bit. I'm gonna set the value 0.28 maybe, and then just go to the edit page, and here just turn on the sparkle, and it's looking absolutely perfect, as you can see. So here we have the first, second, and the third slide. And after that, let me add the burn transition between both the clips. So place the CDI in between both the clips, and this is the burn transition. Just drag and drop the burn transition on the timeline. You can see here, and I'm gonna place the burn transition just like that. Make sure the white section is in center, and do the same thing for the third one. So simply hold Alt on the keyboard, create a copy, and place the burn transition right over here. And what we have to do is select the burn transition, go to inspector window, and this is the composite mode. Let's change this to screen mode for both the layers. Perfect. And here you can see the burn transition. And let me show you one thing for the starting and the end. Simply select the burn transition, hold Alt on the keyboard, and drag it like this. Place the CDI at the center of this transition where the white portion is. Select a blade tool, add a cut right there. Select the first part and place it at the end. Select the second part and place it at very beginning. Just place it right over here. And now it's almost done. So just go to very first frame of this animation, turn on the loop button, hit Control F to full screen, and let's have a look. Alright, it is looking pretty amazing, right? So that is the wrap for today. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial and get the value from it. If you did, then please subscribe to this channel if you haven't yet, and like this video to appreciate my hard work, and also do comment below this video if you have any question or thoughts. My name is Vikash, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye-bye.